Oh my gosh! Hey. It's great to see you guys. How you guys been? How you doing?
Look, things aren't going well at the office.
Yeah, we need you back, dude.
I miss you guys so much, but I don't think Brad is gonna have me back.
You have to prove you belong back.
Yeah, prove you're tough, and he'll take you back.
All right, guys. I gotta go get ready for this. And you can have your dream of the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. And nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Snowman in July? Can't have this. Gotta get ready for my fight. Sorry, Mr. Snowman. We'll see you in December. When you're the one left standing there, you reach the final bell. You're the best. Oh my god! Alright guys, I hope you appreciate this. Doing it for you, Anthony Snowy, big time match right now.
It's gonna be awesome.
Where are they?
In the middle of the ring.
What's the box?
Where are the fighters?
I don't know. Is anyone expecting
maybe we
anything?
Have boxing gloves.
Does it? No, put it off.
Oh jeez. Oh,
no. You know what? This absolutely crossed the line. This is ridiculous. Snowy's gone too far now, Brad. I'm done with him. He's gotta go.
Could have hurt him.
You know what? I agree with you guys. Snowy went too far. Putting Anthony unconscious in a box? This is crazy. You know what? I love that. Snowy's the man. Snowy wins. Pack him up. Send him out to wherever you got him. I want him out of here.
Are you being serious?
Put some stamps on him and get him out of here.
I actually have stamps in my desk.
Well, get them unless you want to be in the box. You're the best around,
and nothing's gonna ever keep you down. Our long national nightmare is over and football is back. But Brad, before we get to the on-field portion of the season, there's a lot of things that have to get worked out this week.
Yeah, usually the marathon off-season is going to turn into a sprint here as we get everything going in a matter of days. Training camp's going to open Wednesday, free agency soon after that. The NFL is going to be all the buzz in a few days of craziness.
And that's because there are so many teams with a lot of questions to deal with, and that is especially true for the local teams.
Yeah, the Patriots and the Giants both have a pair of disgruntled players, Osiemura on the Giants side, Logan Mankins on the Patriots side. Both were involved in that lawsuit, the Brady versus NFL antitrust suit. And we'll see what happens with that. The Patriots or the Giants, will they step up and give them new contracts? They don't have to, but we'll see if they do.
And a couple Jets fans here, we have a lot of questions for our team.
There's going to be a lot of questions surrounding the Jets. Practically their entire wide receiver corps is free agents. Santonio Holmes, Brad Smith, Braylon Edwards. Will they bring one of those back? Will they bring two or three back? Or will they replace one with Randy Moss, Plaxico Burress? It's up in the air. Antonio Cromartie, also a big-time free agent. We'll see what happens with the Jets.
Is Nnamdi Asamoah coming to New York?
We'll see. If they can give him Darrelle Revis money, which we would never thought offseason, they can do that. If you can bring him in for that money, he's going to want a lot. But if they can, bring him in. Team with Revis, oh my God.
And training camps will be interesting too, because when we talked to Nico Koutavidis from Tampa here on Sports Page Online, he was saying the rookies are going to have a big problem.
Absolutely. They didn't get their playbooks right away. No off-season training. It's going to be really tough on the rookies, rookie free agents. They're going to have it even tougher. Usually you see a lot of rookies contribute right away. That's probably not going to happen this year. Maybe in the second half of the season you'll start to see that from the really good players. Otherwise, it's going to be a steep learning curve for those guys.
One thing is certain, it's going to be an interesting offseason, but we're happy football's back. And now here's Joe following the Southington American Legion team.
It took some late-inning theatrics and a rain delay, but Middletown ended Southington's season with a 5-4 walk-off victory at Palmer Field Monday. Alex Roger gave up the game-winning hit when an error by first baseman Zach Niles allowed the winning run to score. Chris Callahan picked 7 effective innings, and Kyle Lentini hit a 3-run home run, but it wasn't enough to keep Southington alive in the tournament. This is the farthest that Post 72 has gotten in over 10 years. Now here's Brad with the final rant.
The NFL players finally voted to accept the owner's CBA, and now we're going to finally have football. Wednesday, it's going to start training camp. After that, there's going to be a hectic few days of free agency, signings, trades. Who knows what's going to happen? But you know what? You could say the owners were wrong. You could say what the players were wrong. Doesn't matter now. We finally have football. And the next few hours, the next few days, the next few weeks are going to be simply awesome. Let's go. It's time for NFL. That's the final take, and that's the final rant here on Sports Page Online.